happy new month and happy new year, because this is the first video I'm doing this year. So on today's episode on the man's guide, we're talking about smoking, the effect of smoking on the lungs. Now I've divided topic into three parts, whereby we have the definition slash introduction, we have the types of smoking, and we have the effects of smoking on the lungs, which is the main topic of today. So now coming down to the definition slash introduction of smoking. Smoking is the act of inhaling and exhaling the fumes coming out from plants, some harmful plants like tobacco, like marijuana, and some other kind of harmful plants. So now coming down to the types of smoking, we have active smokers and we have passive smokers. Active smokers are smokers that take at least one cigarette per day. They can't do without smoking a day. They can take up to 10 cigarettes per day, but they cannot do without taking a cigarette per day. While passive smokers are non-smokers, they don't smoke, but they inhale the smoke coming out from the cigarettes taken by active smokers. So and from smokes around them, fumes from smokes around them, like those people cooking in the kitchen, frying and burning all the plantain, people burning bushes, all those smokes, we are one way or the other passive smokers. So we have to regulate the way we inhale these fumes so that they don't damage our organs. So now coming down to the effects of smoking on our body system, particularly the lungs. So number one, the first effect of smoking on the lungs is lung cancer. We have several effects, like 10. I'm going to be giving out 10 effects of smoking on the lungs. Right, the first one is lung cancer. Smoking causes lung cancer because when we smoke, the smoking irritates the lungs and the air sacs instead. It irritates the respiratory system by damaging the cells lining the lungs. There are cells, we have epithelial cells that line our body organs. They serve as a protective function, you understand? So that what we swallow or what we take in our body, the air we breathe, you understand, does not affect the organ themselves. And if they want to do any damage, they will do the damage to the membrane lining these organs. So now, when you smoke, you irritate the cells lining the lungs, you understand? Now this irritation causes damages to the cells, whereby at first when you start smoking, the body tries to normalize the the damage by restoring the damage, you know, by repairing it over and over again. But you get a particular period of time whereby the cells lining the lungs cannot be repaired again. They're already beyond damage and they get irritated and their normal ability can be displaced and they start giving out abnormal functions by replicating their cells unnecessarily, which can lead to lung cancer. So smoking causes lung cancer. The second effect is COPD, that's chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Now how does smoking affect cause chronic obstructive pulmonary disease? Like I've said earlier, smoking irritates the respiratory tract. It irritates the airways and the air sacs, and by causing the air sacs to swell and to expand, and it reduces the immune system of the cells lining the lungs, you understand, the immunity, the ability of the lungs to protect the body against infections, you understand, because when we breathe in a lot of things, we breathe in microorganisms, we breathe in everything, and the lungs serves as a filter to, you understand, to regulate the amount of microorganisms coming inside. They do all their things, they work, you understand, to destroy all these microorganisms, either by phagocytosis and all those stuff, but I will not be listing them today. The main point is for you to find out that smoking causes chronic obstructive pulmonary disease by destroying the lung ability to fight against infection and by causing swelling of the episodes. Now, when you have chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, you find it difficult to perform tasky functions. You can, at first, you can start by you finding it difficult to play with children. Then it leads to you having difficulty in climbing steps. Then it leads to you having difficulty in even opening your door. Maybe somebody just comes to greet you, knocks on the door, you find a problem standing up to the lock. To open the door for the person. So chronic obstructive pulmonary disease can also be caused by smoking. Smoking, in fact, causes 80% of COPD.